Hey everybody, Luke back with the breakdown. Today we're going to be doing some breaking news. Yes, Amazon Pantry has shut down the very popular, or at least used to be very popular, service that offered the ability to ship some groceries, as long as they weren't frozen or cold needing, to your home for $5.99 per 45-pound box. It was kind of a good idea at the time, and it gave you the ability to bulk buy online through Amazon things like 12 packs of Coke, chips, and more. Now, though, if you're probably like me, when you first heard this news, you said, no, I love that service. And then you thought, hey, it's been a very long time since I used it. Well, there's a lot of better services now on the market, and I'm sure that was one of the main reasons why Amazon shut it down. And we'll talk about that in a minute. First, though, if you're new here, do me a big favor. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that thumbs up. It really does help us because it lets YouTube know you enjoy what we do here. Now, if you're new here, also follow me on Twitter. We post a lot more stories like this where you could have heard about this news even before the video went live. All right, so Amazon Pantry, $5.99 per 45-pound box. What options could replace it? Well, here's my top five picks. Start off with Amazon Prime Now. Prime Now is the same-day delivery service that gives you even groceries and other items within a few hours often. Now, the downside to this is its market, its area it covers is very small. When I was at Disney World, I could get it, but here in my hometown in Michigan, even though we're the second largest town in Michigan, just not an option. We do have a new fulfillment center that just opened up recently. Hopefully that means we'll get Prime Now. But even then, I noticed some of the selection of grocery items and more isn't what Pantry had. Some types of 12 packs of Coke and other things weren't there like they used to be on Pantry. So what other options are there? Well, my number one option to replace Pantry has to probably be Walmart Plus. Downside is you either need to pay per delivery again, or you need to pay for a subscription per year. And if you get a lot of groceries delivered like I do, taking advantage of that, it's probably worth it. The yearly membership works out to be a lot less than the average single delivery per month. So if you get one delivery or more through a service like Instacart, etc., I would encourage you to check them out. Now, Walmart Plus doesn't just give you dry goods like Coke and chips and bread, but you can also get frozen items. And really everything from the Walmart store is there. And I will have to say, of all the options, this one's probably the best. The thing I like about Walmart Plus is that they will actually go out and have their staff pick your order. So Walmart employees go around and pull the orders, put them in the back, and then a driver from a third-party service picks it up and delivers it to your home. Unlike a lot of the other services where third-party employees are going into the store and doing your grocery shopping, which often they may not be as trained. Since they're just a regular person walking in there buying for you, they may not know where everything is in the store. Also, Walmart Plus, I find, has a much better ability to track what's currently available in the store versus other companies. So keep that in mind. Those are my two reasons. I like the fact that Walmart employees pull it. Then they sent me a message where I get a list of changes. I don't need to go back and like always have my phone on me to wait for the shopper to text me saying, would you like a change? So that's important to remember. Check that out. I'll put a link to these options down below. Next up is Instacart. Instacart is a service that works with a host of smaller grocery stores and companies out there to go and deliver groceries to you. The great thing about Instacart is they're very good about getting same-day deliveries. I found that they have a large number of people out there, and they do supply bags to their employees for frozen goods and items. At least they did when I used to use it. You can also get a yearly subscription for free delivery. Of course, tipping is extra on top of that. Next up is Shipit. This one is really growing. It's probably one of the bigger ones now, very much like Instacart, partners with a lot of smaller grocery stores and other stores. Through Instacart and Shipit, you can also get non-big grocery stores. I noticed Costco and other places are popping up in the Sam's Club for delivery. Be aware of limited areas, limited variety, so where you shop could be different. I saw on Instacart in my area, they had a pet supply store, so I could get my pet goods delivered and more. So keep that out there. And lastly, one of the big items here that can replace Amazon Prime Pantry is my local grocery store chain. Now, this one is a little complicated. You got to find your local grocery store and see what they're using. Some are just doing curbside. Some are doing delivery. Sometimes it's through third parties, like they use Shipit or Instacart. Other times they use their own employees. So you got to go to their website and see what they're offering. Again, though, it's hit and miss. The quality of those services vary dramatically depending on who you use. Again, though, if you live in an Amazon Now area, that's not a bad option, especially if you're already in the Amazon ecosystem. But if not, I really do think Walmart Plus is probably going to be your best option. Again, for a few reasons. Number one, they pull it, so their employees pull it. They know the store. This is all they do. They just pull items for people all day. They have a much better ability to track the items. Now, I do want to say, though, often if you order for like tomorrow, you place your order, and it may be on the shelves now, but by the time they go to pull it, it may have been sold. So keep that in mind. That still happens. And unlike many of the others, I noticed with some of the competitors, not all, but they substitute you an item to a more expensive version, they charge you a lot more. If you're not careful, you can suddenly get a much more expensive item than what you wanted. Walmart Plus, at least in my experience so far, let me know if anybody's had this happen to them, where you get charged more. When there's a substitution, it's always the same price or less. They don't charge you more later. So let me know. The only exception for that is weighted goods. And they warn you, you know, if you're buying grapes, it's a per pound kind of weight. The price will vary slightly depending on it. But I've never had a dramatic change from what they quoted me on the website to what I actually paid when they weighed my grapes or oranges or whatever it is that they're using that has to be weighed. So keep that in mind. I also like how they put it in the back in the cooler. And then they give you like, hey, you have 2 hours to confirm or deny the changes. And keep that in mind. Now, the downside to Walmart Plus, and this could just be in my area, is it seems to be very busy. The ability to go and get my order when I want it same day without paying an additional fee is kind of tough. They do offer, if it's available, if there's enough slots, a delivery within 2 hours if you pay extra. Though I find usually a little after breakfast and typically before lunch, same day regular free delivery through Walmart Plus is sold out. Everybody's claimed all the times in my area. Now, my area could be a little different. We're not a huge Walmart area. Meijer is the big shopping here. And honestly, I prefer Meijer, but not their delivery. They had a lot of issues with their delivery. So that could be my issue because there's only three Walmarts, in a town that is considerably larger than, you know, three should dictate because there's so many Meijers. So it'll be interesting. But you let me know, what is your favorite replacement for Amazon Pantry? Did you use Amazon Pantry? And if so, what would you recommend to replace it? And of these options, what would you pick? All right, that's it. If you are new here, do me a big favor, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. I would really appreciate it because it lets YouTube know you enjoy what we do here. And hopefully we can help you learn something new. Thanks for your support. We'll be back real soon with another video.